Hi, my name is Kyle Chester Marsden and welcome to our how-to series here at Fieldpiece Instruments. Today, I'll be showing you how to view vacuum measurements from the Fieldpiece MG44 wireless vacuum gauge directly on the SMAN manifolds. Now before we start, I want to address that the Fieldpiece SM480 and the Fieldpiece SM380 manifolds have an integrated vacuum sensor. So why would you want to connect the MG44 to the screen when you already have a sensor inside the manifold block? The answer to that is that in order to take the best vacuum measurements on a refrigeration or air conditioning system, it's very important that you place the vacuum sensor as far away from the vacuum pump as possible. So ideally, the furthest service port away from where the vacuum pump is connected. Now, this is not always possible. And so this is where our convenient onboard vacuum sensors in the SM480 and the SM380 can be really, really useful. Otherwise, if you have the opportunity to connect to an external vacuum gauge to a system, certainly at the furthest point, then this is always going to give you a more accurate ultimate vacuum reading. Now, let's get into it. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to ensure all of our devices are powered on and that the relevant tools are within the wireless range. It's a good time to remind you that the JobLink enabled products such as the Fieldpiece wireless manifold and the Fieldpiece wireless vacuum gauge have a wireless range of over 300 meters, so we shouldn't see any issues here today. So we can power these tools on by just pressing and holding the power button on each tool until the display lights up on the manifold and until the display lights up on the MG44. We can then press the blue power buttons one more time to illuminate the backlight on both displays. Once we have everything powered on, we need to ensure that the wireless functionality is turned on both tools. So starting with the manifold, and to do this, we simply press and hold the wireless on-off button until you see the display show the wireless symbol with on next to it, and then we know that we're good to carry on. And now we go to the vacuum gauge. All we need to do is press and hold the menu button on the top here, and then scroll along using the next button until we see the word start with the wireless symbol next to it. Once we see it, we just hit the enter button one more time to confirm and save. And this then turns the wireless communication on. To ensure that the vacuum gauge is paired and synced to the manifold, we need to go into the menu items of our manifold and find wireless sources. So to do this, we just press the menu button, and then we scroll using the up or down arrows on the menu, and we find the wireless sources menu item, and then we can just press enter. Now the SMAN digital manifold will always default to looking for a wireless psychrometer as the first tool it looks to connect to. And so in this instance, that's not what we're looking for. So we need to just scroll through the list until we find the correct item, which is when we see the word vacuum displayed on the screen. So to select this and confirm that this is what we're wanting to search for, we now just need to press enter one more time, and this will then start scanning for a wireless vacuum gauge in the area. So as you can see here, the default setting is the onboard vacuum gauge, but if we now press the up or down arrow, it will show the results of any wireless tools in the area. So let's just do that. And as you can see, it has found our vacuum gauge there with the ID number 0125. And we can just check the back of the vacuum gauge to confirm that that ID number matches the unit by cross-referencing the number on the back. So once we're happy with this, we can go ahead and press enter one more time, and that will save this wireless connection. Once we've done this, we can then actually hit the menu button to take us back to our home screen, because we now have the wireless vacuum gauge connected. And so what you'll notice here is that the home screen is not displaying a vacuum pressure right now, and that is because a vacuum pressure is currently not present on the MG44. So to get a value to show on the screen here, we're going to need to connect the vacuum gauge to one of our vacuum pumps and emulate a vacuum pressure. So let's get into that now. Okay, so I've now connected the MG44 up to our VPX7 vacuum pump, and I'm about to turn it on. You'll see that once the vacuum gauge registers a vacuum pressure below 20 torr or 20,000 microns, that it will display a value on the screen. Okay, so you can see clearly that the manifold is now showing the measurement value of the vacuum gauge completely wirelessly. And it's using this method which allows you to place the vacuum gauge on the furthest point on the system while still being able to keep an eye on the reading, even in front of your manifold. Okay, so that is how to view and use our wireless vacuum gauge, the MG44, with our wireless manifolds, the SMAN. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more great videos.